1978 in Prague, we only won one gold medal on the track, but it really was a terrific run by Steve Ovett. In fact, after the race, Emil Zatopek was quoted widely as saying that was the greatest race he'd ever seen.
And then Bayer has gone off straight in front. Bayer now with Gonzalez in second place. In third place is Giessen of Switzerland. Right on the outside is Marajo of France. The two Frenchmen in the first four. And Robson, three from the back. Eamon Coughlin next to the back. So it's Bayer in front now, this big, powerful gold medalist in the 800 metres. And he slowed it down. After the initial burst, he slowed it right down, and Gonzalez is pressing him on the outside, this small Frenchman. Mario of France is following him. Then Giessen on the curb in fourth place. Coming up on the outside is Vessinghager, who qualified as one of the fastest losers. Three to go. And Gonzalez leads for France. Some pushing and so on. Inevitable bunching in a field of 12. Gonzalez still leads. Bayer in second place. Mario of France is third. Giessen, Switzerland, fourth. Vessinghager, West Germany, five. Coming up to the end of the first lap at the time, 57.5. Gonzalez getting away from Bayer. Vessinghager's not going to allow the gap to develop. He was desperately disappointed when he thought he hadn't qualified, but he did get through as the fastest loser. Ovett moves smoothly through into third place. Bayer will be watching him like a hawk. Then Jürgen Straub with the two East Germans now, with Ovett in their sights. Eamon Coughlin moving up on the outside. Really outstanding Irish athlete with a real chance in this event. Fourth in the Olympic Games. Robson's got off the curb. Moorcroft's moving out as well. Following, Robson's following Moorcroft through. And Dave Moorcroft makes his move through, keeping out of trouble. Moorcroft always sound, unspectacular, but he's usually there at the finish when it matters most. And again, they're bunching and banging. Coming round to complete two laps, a fantastic atmosphere in the stadium. Loikkanen of Finland, who's got a tremendous finish, is just watching them as they go through 800, 157. France in front, West Germany second, Great Britain third, Ireland four, East Germany five, Great Britain six, East Germany seven, Switzerland eight. And still the little Frenchman driving on. Vessinghager tracking him all the time. Broke 3 minutes 40 seconds for 1500 metres, more than any other athlete in the world last year. Steve Ovett waits and waits. This should be his best event, but he's had a real knock, of course, in being beaten. And there's Straub, the East German, moving up on the outside, and Ovett may get boxed slightly. Loikkanen, this dangerous fin comes through, and Loikkanen looks very smooth. This time the bell, and Ovett's not trapped. He's moving up on the outside. Straub, East Germany, is in front. In second place, Loikkanen. Third, Eamon Coughlin. And Ovett goes up with Moorcroft following him on the outside. Forced to go wide. They're all in with a chance still, all 12 of them. 300 metres left and the strike is on. It's Loikkanen of Finland. And Ovett goes with him. Moorcroft is there as well. And Bayer can't find anything. He's next to the back. Ovett tracks Loikkanen with 200 to go. And there goes Ovett. Is this the compensation for Ovett? He's now 4 metres clear. 5 metres clear. 6 metres clear, and Moorcroft looks round for trouble. He's in third place. Ovett is away and clear, and this could be Britain's first gold medal in these championships. He's got to keep driving, but surely nothing can stop him now, and he's already celebrating. Ovett wins in customary style. In second place, Eamon Coughlin of Ireland, and third is Moorcroft of Great Britain. Fourth, Vessinghager, five, Loikkanen, six was Mario, seven was Straub, and eighth, Robson. So, at last, Britain has got a gold medal in these championships, and Ovett really never made it appear to be in doubt. The time, 3 minutes 35.57, which is a new championship record by 3 seconds.
It's amazing to think that that was the only title he ever won at 1500 metres, because he looked then that day as though he'd win everything. And I think in second place, Eamon Coughlin, and third place, Dave Moorcroft, and in fourth place, Thomas Vessinghager. I think the three of them got together afterwards, actually, and discussed it, because after that race, the three of them moved up to 5,000 metres. They'd had enough at 1,500 metres. And the significance of it was that Eamon Coughlin went on to become the world champion at 5,000 metres. Dave Moorcroft went on to become the world record holder at 5,000 metres. And Thomas Vessinghager went on to become the European champion at 5,000 metres. So I think Steve Ovett changed the course of the history books at 1,500 metres and 5,000 metres with his performance in Prague.